do is I'm going to go ahead and do just some special little design. Okay, here we go. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. It's going to be a little crisscross pattern. Make it really stand out and look different. I'll give it that different look. That's kind of what it's all about, you know, trying to be different than everybody else. So I'm just kind of using my imagination and kind of going for it. And sometimes when you do this, it doesn't come out perfect. But if you just have a positive attitude, if you have a positive attitude, it'll eventually come out better than what you were seeing in your head. So, as you can see, this takes a long time to do this. This is not an easy job. What you're seeing here, I'm overlaying everything, I'm overlapping everything, see? I started at the bottom, I'm working my way to the top coat. We gotta watch this paint because it dries really fast. We don't want real thick swashes on it. We want thin swashes, so you gotta keep your... paint thin. It actually takes a while to do this, believe it or not. So let me finish this out and we'll come back and look at the finished product and we'll go over everything and see what's going on with it. Alright, what I did, if you look, I went ahead and drew out a piece of chalk what I'm going to put. I'm just going to say Wild Willies, okay? And things looking really good. I like the way it's coming out. And what we're going to do, we're going to paint Wild Willies with white, and we'll go over some colors. And maybe jazz up our little design in the center here, and we're probably going to be done with it. We'll get a good overall look at it. That's really starting to look pretty nice. Okay, we've got our white right here. What am I doing? I got some reducer down here, see? I'm just going to go ahead and a little bit, mix it up. And once again, I'm going to let you know I am not a pinstriper. Okay, I don't claim to be a fancy pinstriper. I don't want to be a fancy pinstriper. This is just an artistic type of pinstriping that you can do yourself. Notice I took the W and I went up even higher. You don't have to follow the chalk line that you put on there. You don't want to. That's actually looking pretty cool. I like the way it looks. now what we're going to do, I'm going to go ahead and outline the Wild Willies with some multicolors. And it should look pretty good. That fucking light is right in my eyes. We're going to come back and check it all out when I'm done. I'm basically going to do the lettering on the colors the same way I did the Willies. And I'll put a few little more stars in it, this, that, and the other. And it should look pretty good. Be right back.
Well, let's zoom out on it, see what...
Well, there you go. Now, when you're painting something like this, you got to visualize the motor in here. So with the motor in here and all the chrome and everything, it's really, really going to look nice. So we got our flames. We got our stitching on our flames going around it. We got a pinstripe. We got the shadows. Okay, we got the Wild Willies. You know, we got a couple little star action going on over here. I might put a couple more of those in. We got the nice pinstriping going on the dash here where, you know, little swirls. And so that approximately took 5.5 to 6 hours to do all that. And, you know, this might not be everybody's, I'm going to be honest with you, I don't even know if Willie guy, crazy man, Larry California guy, Willie's man is really going to like it. I don't know. I know it's going to look good because I can see it with the motor and the chrome in it, but I don't know, you know. I like it. It looks pretty cool. It's one of a kind. It's hand painted. You know, I don't claim to be a pinstriper, but I can do my own designs. And that's an example, another example from my friend Pete, your friend Pete, Last Chance Pete. That's another example of, you know, do it your way, okay? Don't worry about what other people think. Because the ending product, it's going to look nice, all right? And I think it looks pretty cool myself. So, it ain't clear-coated yet, so we can't get the full effect of it. I got to go back and touch up some of the orange and some of the yellow. And clean the frame up where I chipped it. Yeah, there's some spot down here, but anyway, there you go. Wild Willie's on its way to California. It's looking good. I like it. The only question is will Larry like it? California Larry, that is. This is Pete. Another episode of Southwest Rod and Custom in action. Another daily adventure in the diary of Southwest Rod and Custom, SWRNC. We'll see you later. We'll see you on the next one. Take it easy. Our Willies is looking good. It's a big fucking job. We ain't even got the underneath of the hood painted yet. I still got to clean all the brackets up and do everything else, but we'll see you later. We'll get a good look at it when it's all clear coated and all finished, and it should look pretty nice. Take it easy. Goodbye, 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 and happy fucking New Year. Take it easy. So we'll be back. This is Pete, Southwest Rod and Custom. That's Bruno. And we're always here, right? So take it easy, have fun, and enjoy what you're doing. See you later.